What's up, nerds? It's your boy, the OG GM, coming to you live on a lovely Friday morning here in Ventura, California. And it's Friday, which means it's time to get on my soapbox, time to toss out some editorials, time to lay down some heel smack, time to generate some heat. Yeah, that's right. It's time to respond to this week's Wheel of Irrelevance as the OSR culture war continues to burn its way through the gaming industry. A lot of slack, a lot of smack talk, a lot of, you know, cheap pops, a lot of people talking shit about other people. And my favorite of all these people are the I know better what Gygax wanted than you did people. Notice none of these people ever actually speak to Luke or Ernie about what their father actually wanted. They're just like, yeah, I know what Gygax wanted. Yeah, Gygax, totally, this is what Gygax intended. Gygax this, Gygax that. They wave Gary's name around like they were personally involved with him. My other favorite one is people talking about their chops, about, you know, I am in the position to tell you how to think about the game because I've been doing this for 20 years. I'm like, look, dude, I've been gaming longer than most of you have been alive. So for you to talk shit about me or people who have been doing this since the 70s, yeah, no, I mean, come on. And if you want to talk about Gary and who's the most elite OSR game masters, who, you know, what was Gary's standards? Well, Gary lays it out pretty correct, you know, matter-of-factly in his autobiography about what it was Gary thought allowed you to consider yourself an elite OSR dungeon master worthy of the golden wisdom that Gygax has brought down from the mountain, like, because right, you know, like right behind Moses going up the mountain to get the Ten Commandments, right behind him was Gygax going, these are the Ten Commandments of D&D that I bring to you, my few chosen ones. Oh yeah, this is totally what Gary wanted. He wanted it to be, it's like, hoorah, rah, rules is written, blah, 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 blah. I know more than you because I've been doing this for 15 years. Oh, you've only been in the industry for 20 years? You can't say you're old school. So someone, once some kid comes out and says they know more about the game than I do because they've been doing it for 15, 20 years, and I'm like, I've been doing it since I was 7, dude. I'm about to turn 56, so you do the math. All right, so here's Gary's list right there. I mean, it's in his autobiography. I'm paraphrasing. But here we go, okay? So, and also I was recently called out, you know, by somebody I used to respect in the gaming industry who decided that I'm an ungodly heathen for reasons. So, and other things. So, okay, yeah. Because I guess these guys like to break kayfabe and bring real-life insecurities into their game. And if they can't insult you about anything else, then they'll play, you know, the base cards. So, question number one. In order to prove if I've earned my RPG chops or not, have I ever played D&D? Yes. Yes, I have. Question number two. How have I ever run D&D? Yes. Yes, I have. Question number three. Have you played multiple editions of D&D? Because there's anywhere between 9, 12, 6, and 32. Every version of Dungeons & Dragons I have played multiple times. Every version of Dungeons & Dragons I have run multiple times. Have you taught anybody to play Dungeons & Dragons? Yes. Yes, I have. Have you played other games besides Dungeons & Dragons? Because remember, Gary was always about other games besides just D&D. He wanted you to play other games. He specifically said, go out, play other games. You know, find stuff that's interesting. Maybe somebody else there is doing something that you can borrow and bring to your game. So have I played other games besides D&D? Yes, yes, I have. Have I run other games besides D&D? Yes, yes, I have. Do I own Dungeons & Dragons? Yes, yes, I do. Do I own copies of other games besides Dungeons & Dragons? Yes, yes, I do. Have I taught people how to play these games? Have I taught D&D? Yep, every version. Have I taught other games? Yep, every version. Have you run your games at a game store and allowed other people to find out about the hobby? Yep. Yes, I have, Gary. I dubbed that. Have you played games at a game store? Yes. Yes, I have. those games been Dungeons & Dragons? Yes. Have those been other games besides Dungeons & Dragons? Yes. Have you run games at a convention? Yes. Yes, I have. Have you played games at a convention? Yes. Yes, I have. Have you written a game? Yes. Yes, I have. So if we go by Gary's list of everything that qualifies you as a dungeon master, worthy of your chops, worthy to say you are, you know, the elite, then yeah, I am. I've been doing it since I was 7. I have run every version of D&D. I have played every version of D&D. I have taught other people how to play D&D. I have run multiple games of different genres from different companies. I have played multiple games of different genres from different companies. I have taught people how to play these games. I have run and played at game stores. I have run and played at conventions. I have run multiple different games, including D&D, at game stores. I have run and played multiple different games besides D&D at local game stores. Same with conventions. I have gone to conventions. I have run. I have played. I have made my own product. I have sold my own product. I have worked with other gaming companies to create product. I have given talks about gaming. I have gamed with people all over the world. So I think I've earned my chops. I think I've earned the right to say a few things about the hobby. And when somebody, you know, needs to play the I'm better than you card in order to, you know, perpetuate this constant clout chasing nonsense that the whole YouTube thing has been. I don't want to start drama, and I don't want to start drama, but here's some genre, but I'm not starting drama, but here's some drama, but I'm not starting drama, but here's some drama stuff in order to try and make me feel like a lesser person because I'm an ungodly heathen, a white belt scrub DM. I don't know. I'm mediocre. You don't know nothing about no game. Oh, you don't know what Gygax wanted. I once was in the same state as Gygax once thought about. I think I've earned my chops. So that is it for today in the why is this a thing? And it's basically, you know, it breaks down to clout chasing, name calling. It's basic, you know, elementary school playground pushing, or, you know, high school, my is bigger than yours. I can, you know, I need to make myself look better by insulting somebody else on the internet. We've always done it. We do it, you know, and if we can play Gygax's name to make us look better, great. We can say, well, I know about you better about the game than you because I've been playing for this long. And it's like, yeah, well, you know what? Here's the list. Here's the list. Have you done everything on this list? Yeah. Have you published? Have you worked for other game companies? Have you taught games? If you've done all that, then maybe, okay, you're in a position to at least talk, get a little snide like I am, and generate a little heat. But if you're just going for the cheap pops, guys, if you're just going for the cheap, oh, well, your hair's blue, so you're a horrible, awful person. You don't know what Gygax wanted. Only I do, because I play rules as written. Nobody plays rules as written. You play rules as perceived. It's already been proven. Yeah. Just, it doesn't need to be a thing. It doesn't need to be the my D&D PP is bigger than your D&D PP because I'm this. Because, yeah, I could say, well, I've done everything, so I'm elite. When you've done half the shit I've done, then maybe you can say you're elite too. But I'm not going to, because I still know there's a lot to learn. And there's still know that there's so many things I can still learn, change, contribute, more games to play, more games to run, more games to learn, more ways to make myself better, more ways to help make the hobby better, more ways to direct the nonstop culture war and name calling and perhaps a better way. Maybe someday we can get back to just playing the stupid game and not name calling and stuff like that. You know, I mean, ungodly heathen. When was the last time you heard somebody call you that? But apparently I am. I'm not OSR enough to be in the OSR. It's just sad that I have to make these little stories that are pointless. I mean, nobody cares what I've done or haven't done in the hobby. Nobody cares what you've done or haven't done in the hobby. Nobody cares if you met Gygax or didn't meet Gygax. Nobody cares if you think you know what Gygax intended or you don't have no idea who Gygax is. Dude, it's a silly game about idiots with sticks going into the forest and fighting monsters. Stop trying to make it something other than it's not.